So, a common misperception on functions of random variables are what? It says, suppose x is a random variable and gx is a real valued function. It says, the expected value of a function of this random variable is represented like this. So, if I want to calculate the expected value of the function of that random variable, which is expected value of g of x, I write this mathematically like this. So, expected value of g of x, my friends, is not equal to g of the expectation of x. Now, check this out. G is a function and expected value is another function. I mean, can you do that in mathematics? Can you do that? F of g of x, can you change the order of the functions? In most of the cases, these two things are not equal, right? So the order of the functions are important. So therefore, in most of the cases, expectation of g of x, expected value of the function, is not equal to the function of the expectation. And a proving example is that expected value of x square is not equal to the square of the expectation. I mean, you should know this because there is a difference between these two, and that difference is called the variance, right? So you calculate the variance, which is supposed to be a positive value. You calculate the variance by taking the difference between these two values. How can these two things be equal? So for a function of a random variable, the expected value of a function of a random variable is not equal to the function of that expectation. However, there are counter examples as well. So there are some functions where this is equal to other one. For example, linear functions. If g is a linear function, my friends, expected value of ax plus b was equal to a times expected value of x plus b. So for linear functions, this may be true. But for other functions, this may not be true. So in most of the cases, it says this is not equal to true, but there are some exceptions like linear functions where this is true. Okay? Now, how about the variance? In most of the cases, again, the variance of gx is not equal to g of variance x. And a proving example is, again, the variance of ax plus b. Remember, it is not equal to a variance x plus b. What was the variance of ax plus b? The variance of ax plus b is equal to a square variance of x. So we take the multiplier outside the variance, a squared after squaring it, and b does not affect anything in the variance. It vanishes. So the distribution of g of x is also different. For example, when you say x is an exponential random variable and g is a function, when you transform this exponential random variable, you may get a totally different random variable. So the function of that random variable may not be exponentially distributed. So we need to identify the expectation and the variance and the distribution of a function of a random variable. And unfortunately, you cannot simply use these equations. They are not true. They are not equal, definitely.